is now live. It's the SuperSport 600, and Zamri Barber will indeed be on pole position. Do you anticipate, do you expect Imhami to be able to go on and win this race?
Well, I believe this is his first pole position here in Sepang. And he won here last year twice, beating Katsuaki Fujiwara. A great battle between him and Fujiwara last year here in Sepang. And he had a good chance to win the race. But then again, this is a SuperSport 600cc. We have few names to look at. Takahashi, Yuki Takahashi, also a good rider from Musashi Bonshi Honda Racing, replacing Tamada. This is Muhammad Zamri Barber, who had a good chance to win the title last year, but unfortunately due to the huge accident in Suzuka, which he did not take part in Suzuka and Autopolis, but he did help Zakwan to win the title.
Certainly did, very much in the veteran stage now. This is Yuki Takahashi, who's from the Musashi Bunsyu Honda team as well. So it's a good start for Honda to get one and two on the grid, yep. But the Kawasaki's will be competing, have no doubts about that.
They already won three times from Kiyonari. And then Azlan Jakamur Zaman, and last year Zakwan Zaidi, they are looking fourth time on the trot for the title riders championship in Zamri Barber and Yuki Takahashi. And this is Yuki Takahashi replacing Makoto Tamada this year, and also a very experienced rider from Japan. And then we have here, this is Ahmad Yudhishthira Manoltech KYT Kawasaki from Indonesia with the guidance from Fujiwara.
We must get the guys to work better on their camera presence, as we instead of pointing to a cartoon on his helmet. So Yudhishthira, a lot expected of him in the Kawasaki garage, and so the familiar black and green livery of Ahmed Yudhishthira is the grid. Zamri, Takahashi and Yudhishthira on the first row.
Then we have Tomoyoshi Koyama fourth on the grid. Followed by, alongside him, is Arancha Matno and Dimas Eki Pratama.
Fadli Imamuddin Inagaki, who I like, and Badrul Hisham on the third row.
Then we have Australian Aaron Morris, 10 on the grid. Ratapong Vilaro from Thailand, 11. 12th on the grid is Noriyuki Haga.
That's remarkable, Haga 12th. Suhatai Aitchison and Jackrit, who can be a very tasty wild card on the fifth row.
16 on the grid is Yuki Ito, down to 16 from 5th yesterday. 17, Rapita Franso Chipto and Mutsinori Okamura, 18 on the grid.
Then you've got Harder, Mickey Blair and Anupab.
And 22nd on the grid is Ahmad Afif Amran from Malaysia and Akichai Chiang Wong, Thailand. 23rd, 24th on the grid, Muhammad Fitri, Ashraf Razali.
And Pong Pira and Ratapong and Akmal Hisham make up the 27 riders who will complete the grid. It's a 25-lap race. It's just the north circuit of Sepang, which means it's very tight and windy after the long home straight here.
Well, based on the tire choice, we're going to expect to see this early speed from Yuki Ito, Hatlancha using soft front tire, and Farid Patrol Hisham. And then Haga also is using soft medium tire.
Keep an eye from Yuki Ito. He's starting on the sixth row of the grid because he was a naughty boy during qualification. But Zamri Barber is the man in possession of pole. What kind of start can Zamri get? Ahmad Yudhishthira in the Kawasaki alongside him. Sandwiched between them is Takahashi. We are off and running the SuperSport 600. Zamri off to a good start, but that is Takahashi, who's got a flyer from P2. And it was Takahashi, or is it Yudhishthira, who's also made a move in there as well. And Zamri Barber reclaimed his position back at the front. So he had a sluggish start, but has fired himself back into the lead around the first two corners. Bit of contact once again as they go through the first two bends. It's caused real problems already so far today, but the SuperSport 600 is up and running and Zamri is away.
Yes, there's no accident in the first corner, and we have a Suzuki in front right now. We have one Suzuki in front with Zamri Barber still leading, and we saw earlier there is a group of Kawasaki riders storming in front. But right now, we have Zamri Barber leading the race, number No, that's not Zamri. I'm so sorry. That's Takahashi, Yuki Takahashi, number 72, leading the race.
He is indeed. Well, he got a flying start. He got caught, and then in the melee, he's been able to sort himself out as they come through the first lap. It is indeed Takahashi from P2 who will cross the line first. Takahashi from Haga. Farid in third place, so Haga has made a terrific start. Haga is up from the seventh row of the grid. He's come through from absolutely nowhere, and Zamri Barber is in fourth.
That shows his experience indeed, from 12th on the grid up to second, but now down to fourth, because we have Zamri is currently third, with still Takahashi leading the race, and then second is before this Haga, Farid Badr Hisham. Yes, it's number 83 in second place. What a surprise.
Zamri just makes a move on the inside, but it's Takahashi who's made a real start. I'm keeping an eye out for Yuki Ito to see.
Yeah, Zamri's making his move now. Then overtaking Farid Badr Hisham to be second in the race behind his teammate.
We've got problems, as you can see.
To one of the rider, the Kawasaki rider.
An early exit, and Haga is still up in that little group. That's a fabulous start from Haga, but Takahashi will cross the line in first place. Ahead of Zamri, Farid, Haga third, Yudhisthira fourth, Koyama is in fifth place.
Well, this is very interesting. Normally in a Super Sport 600cc, we have few riders in front already pulling from the group, but now we have a huge group in front. Here, real battle going on between Takahashi, Zamri, and then Farid Badr Hisham, Haga, Yudhisthira, Koyama, all in front now. Well, less than a second between them.
Takahashi in the lead. Just looking at Haga. Haga came from 1, 2, 3, fourth row of the grid, 12th position he was starting. It's a terrific effort for him to get up so tight. Ahmed Yudhisthira hanging on there in fifth place. He's probably now up into, this is the battle for P3 at the moment.
This is a good start by the Kawasaki team. We have Yudhisthira number 33, and 83 is Muhammad Farid Badr Hisham, third and fourth in the race, with Haga, she's now a fourth. And I think I saw a yellow bike behind there. It's the number, yes, that's Inagaki. That's Inagaki right behind Haga.
Inagaki on bike number 18, as you say, in the yellow livery. But this is the start, and it's been a very pacey start from Takahashi. Hasn't been able to pull any great distance away, though. The lead was 0.698 of a second, which I suppose is quite healthy. But as you can see, there's a trail behind him of Zamri Barber in second place. Farid was third. Yudhisthira, I think, is the man now up into third place. And Haga still hanging in there in the top five.
Yudhisthira is the one of the group for Kawasaki to begin their title this year from the Honda of Musashi Bonshu Honda Racing. And but it seems now the two Musashi Bonshu Honda Racing riders leading the race is Takahashi and Zamri Barber. But 0.6 seconds is not safe yet for Takahashi, with 21 left to go after this lap.
Honda 1 and 2, Kawasaki 3 and 4, the Suzuki of Noriyuki Haga is up into fifth place. We're welcoming Suzuki back into the Supersport 600s, and they're immediately making an impact with Noriyuki Haga.
And even though he's struggling in the qualifying yesterday, but in the race he's shown his capability from 12th on the grid. Now Haga is currently fifth in the race. This is between Takahashi and Zamri Barber. Zamri seems to be faster in the third lap for Zamri and Takahashi.
Inagaki has dropped back just a little bit. He was challenging for third at one stage. He's dropped down now into seventh place. As looking a little bit further down the field, this is Koyama currently in fourth, and it's getting a little bit spread out. It's Inagaki right at the back there. There he is, bike number 18, Inagaki on the tail of Farid Badr Hisham.
It's very close between Farid Inagaki and Haga right now. We are looking very traffic. Popan Sukipto down right behind Azan Shah Muhammad Do. And still in front of Takahashi and Zamri Barber. And Yudhisthira is now closing the gap between him and Zamri.
Everybody safely through. Okamura, the last one through on the bike out racing. Noriyuki Haga. Puts pressure on. Yudhistira is in third. Koyama fourth. Noriyuki Haga fifth. And Farid Badral in sixth place. But still the lead is held by Yuki Takahashi. And Zamri Barbara second. Takahashi. What was his tire setup for Takahashi? Medium, I think.
Yeah, Takahashi, he's using medium and medium. Both of the Musashi Ponsu Honda rider is using medium front and medium rear.
In fact, all three of the first row, first grid, including Zamri, deciding medium, and so far it's working well. Yudhistira, also medium, he's up into third. So it's 1-2-3, Takahashi, Zamri, and Yudhistira, all three from the first row of the grid.
Yeah, watch out for Yuki Ito. I think Yuki Ito is making his move now. That's number 76. Now Yuki Ito starting 16 on the grid. That's not a good start for Yuki Ito, but he's currently ninth right now. Yuki Ito, right behind Ratapong Wilarot.
He's only 5.6 seconds down on the race leaders as well, and we've seen the speed of Yuki Ito and his competitiveness as well. And so he's making a move there. Inagaki leading that little posse, although Inagaki has just been shoved aside there. Inagaki is going backwards because that was Noriyuki Haga going on inside Inagaki.
Yeah, Yuki Ito is trying to get past Ratapong or Wilarot first before Inagaki, Haga and Farid Mudrisham not very far behind him. With 19 left to go, 5 seconds behind the leader. He needs to get past the front group if he has any chance at all to get into the front group.
It does look to be a convincing lead right at the very front for Takahashi, but it's 0.5 ahead of Zamri Barber, who's 1.1 ahead of Yudhistira in third place. Koyama fourth, Inagaki fifth, and Haga on the Suzuki is in sixth place. But it's pretty tight and pretty congested right the way down to 10th or 11th, where Fadli Imamuddin is holding 10th place.
It looks like we just continue where we left last year with the two Musashi Ponsu Honda Racing continue to dominate the race in front. This is the group that we are looking at, and Yuki has already made his move in front of Yuki before this Ratapong. Then he has Haga, Farid Banukisham, that's Haga. Now he's trying to make his move on Haga.
Just to let you know, Tiger Harder is a long way down here. I think he was involved in one of the collisions that put him off, but he's carrying on. But Akachai is out of the race. He went out after six laps. Farah's Nasir, Amiral Arif Musa, and Mitsunori Okamura also out of the race.
17 laps to go. Still a great race, a great battle there with Yuki Ito. Is making his move now on Haga. A moment for Ito, but still. Still maintaining that now, leading Haga, just get overtook Haga, and now in front of him is Farid Badrul Hisham.
Ito is up to 8th place, I understand, and he's putting pressure on Haga there. We're looking at the front as Yudhistira and Koyama are battling for 3rd and 4th place respectively. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, Yudhistira on the Kawasaki Inagaki. Ooh. Now that is,
that's his number 30.
Anubhav Samoon. And he'll need a little bit of treatment here.
Who's a high side for Anubhav Samoon on the track?
He's up and walking and out of the way, but has clearly taken a knock and is down injured. We've had one or two incidents already here on this Super Sunday in Sepang. But Takashi leads from Zamri Barber.
Zamri is now closing on Takahashi on 0.3 seconds. I believe he'll make his move anytime soon. And both rider from the Musashi Ponsu Honda Racing.
Best lap time 105.115 has come from Ahmad Yudhistira so far. 16 laps to go. We've been racing for 10 minutes, and in those 10 minutes, I tell you, Yuki Takahashi has virtually led from start to finish, but Zamri Barber is not letting up on him. In fact, Zamri is pressurizing him, just looking to see if he can cause an error from Yuki Takahashi.
Well, Zamri is definitely faster in the last two laps. than Takahashi. But I'm looking at where is Yuki Hito now, 6.9 seconds behind the leader of the race, Takahashi and Zamri Baba. There you go, Takahashi. Zamri now is trying to make his move in the first corner, but still Takahashi is keeping his lead in front of Zamri, Yudhishthira, Koyama, Inagaki and Yuki Hito now up to
sixth place
with 5 or 7 seconds behind Takahashi and Zamri Baba.
But he's got clean track ahead of him, Yuki Hito. He's got 2 seconds to make up on Makoto Inagaki to get up into fifth place. So you've got these four away: Takahashi, Zamri, Yudhishthira and Koyama. Then you've got Inagaki, and then you've got Yuki Hito. And we'll keep a close eye on bike number 76, Yuki Hito. This is Inagaki, and the gap between him and Yuki Hito there is in sixth place. Good camera work picking out the stories that are emerging, because Yuki Hito, as you say, started 16, now up to 6, and still plenty of time to go in this race, Harmy.
Yeah, it's a good race for Yuki Hito, now up to 6, but he still has a lot of work to do. In front of him is Inagaki. We see the gap, the distance. Well, we can see Yuki Hito there, still in the same camera shot, so still a good news for Yuki Hito. But well, on the paper, he's 7.1 second behind Yuki and Yuki Takahashi and Zamri Baba.
But he is closing in on Makoto Inagaki. Well, we're looking at this. So that's Inagaki in the yellow, bike number 5. Hito making the run and really, really pushing hard there. He's a thrilling racer, is Yuki Hito. He's a suspect to the odd moment of madness, but my word, he's flying and he's throwing his whole body into that just to try and pull a little bit closer into Inagaki. You never know. Once he gets on Inagaki, then he'll have Koyama and Yudhishthira in his sights.
The only problem for Yuki Hito right now is that he's using a soft front tire. So soon towards the end of the race, he will lose his grip. So now is the time that he needs to get faster. He needs to maintain the speed. That is, he's getting 105.5 second, and to get ahead of Inagaki and Koyama.
There's the Kawasaki of Ahmad Yudhishthira. Knee tight to the track. It's physically demanding to swing the bike left and right and to get that low to the floor. But he's doing it superbly, Ahmad Yudhishthira. Koyama in fourth, best lap 105.435. The best lap in the race so far, 105.115.
Yes, by Yudhishthira. And we have 9 riders who are doing 105 right now on the track. And most of them are using medium. And this is Koyama. Tomoshi Koyama behind Yudhishthira, making his move on Yudhishthira right now, closing the gap between the two riders.
As we look at the battle for P3, I can tell you Noriyuki Haga, who got up into the front 4 or 5, he's dropped down quite a bit, the Suzuki racer. He's now outside the top 10. So Zamri is leading from Takahashi.
Yeah,
outside, Zamri's taking the lead. Yudhishthira third, Koyama fourth. And we're still looking as Inagaki and Hito maybe come through.
Well, Inagaki is using medium, and he's maintaining his speed. But Yuki Hito now 7.2 seconds behind Zamri and Takahashi. That's not good for Yuki Hito. He needs to have the speed at the early part of the race, but we have 12 laps to go. And it looks like these two riders now, they are battling each other to win the first race of the first round.
Certainly does. Yuki Hito is actually going backwards. The soft tire compound may well be working against him now. This is the battle for P1. Zamri Baba of Malaysia up against his Musashi Bunsu Honda teammate Yuki Takahashi. There is 0.23 of a second between them. A further 3 seconds before Ahmad Yudhishthira, Koyama, Inagaki and Hito is losing quite dramatically time on Inagaki. So Hito is out of the reckoning by my reckoning. Ratapong in sixth, Dimaseki seventh. Also going downwards is Noriyuki Haga.
Let's take a look at Yudhishthira gap now, 3 seconds behind Yuki Takahashi and Zamri Baba. And Koyama, in fact, is making his move on Yudhishthira right now. And Yudhishthira using medium compound rear and front. And Inagaki also is using medium front and medium rear for the race. And Yudhishthira is working so hard to keep his place. And this is Yuki Ito. Now Yuki Ito 7.4 seconds behind Zamri and Yuki Takahashi. And around 3 seconds behind Inagaki.
He's going a little bit backwards, is Yuki Ito. We were expecting a charge, but that soft tyre compound on the front tyre. Yeah. Counting against them, there is the gap. This is the battle for P3. Yudhishthira goes through Inagaki. Here is Yuki Ito.
Yes, we have, in fact, Ratapong Wilarot now closing behind Yuki Ito. So Yuki has his own problem right now with Ratapong Wilarot, Dimas Eki Pratama and Farid Badruk Hisham now closing on him.
Also the speedster Jakrit Sawangsat from AP Honda Racing Thailand is in that little group as well, but Hara, I'm afraid to say, for Suzuki is being dropped. There's the five, and Ito is struggling to just hold on to that bike.
Ito used a medium yesterday during a practice session, and he said a good time, but I believe because due to his position on the grid, 16 on the grid, he needs the speed, early speed to be in front, but it seems that now the tyre is working against him in the later part of the race.
Let's not forget though why he was 16th on the grid, because of his own ill discipline. Now then, at the front, Takahashi has overtaken Zamri Baba. They're just swapping positions. Yudhishthira holds on to P3 ahead of Tomoyoshi Koyama on the T-Pro Yuzi Honda. And Inagaki is closing in. Inagaki, yes, is making this a three-way battle for third.
This is a battle of his own for third, fourth and fifth. Still, Ahmad Yudhishthira is maintaining his third place. And Koyama now is making his move from the inside. Koyama now go to third. Down that for Ahmad Yudhishthira for the Manual Tech KYT Kawasaki. So Koyama for the T-Pro Yuzi Honda NTS now up to third. But still, they are 3.3 seconds behind Zamri and Takahashi.
Yudhishthira has a little look back, but he can't get close to Koyama, so Koyama is, as you say, into third place as they go across the line with 8 laps to go. It's Takahashi from Zamri Baba, from Koyama, from Yudhishthira, Inagaki, and a long way down, Ito is going backwards. He's lost half a second on Inagaki there, and now he's coming under pressure from Ratapong.
It looks like Takahashi has regained his lead in front of Zamri Baba. Part of the strategy, or there's the team order going on, we don't know, but
you're not suggesting it is team orders, surely.
Zamri Baba now is leading Zamri.
Takahashi from Zamri. It's a powerful performance, because these are now, they're 3.5 seconds clear of the rest of the field, which is a good quality field. This is true world-class racing.
Well, we have two of their former riders for the Musashi Bonshu Honda Racing. In fact, the both riders won the title in 2013 and 14. Azlancha Kamaruzaman and Zakwan Zaidi now racing in Moto 2 in the World Grand Prix. That shows how high is the standard of ARRC. And now we have Yuki Takahashi and Zamri Baba in front with a gap of 3.9 seconds before this, in front of this group, Koyama, Yudhishthira and Inagaki.
Koyama still holding on to third and looking relatively comfortable. He was happy just sitting on the shoulder of Yudhishthira, but then decided enough was enough. If he's going to make a move on the front two, he needs to make it pretty quickly, because there's only 7 laps to go. We're approaching the final quarter of this Supersport 600cc race number one, on event number one of the season here in Sepang, Malaysia.
There's a backmarker behind Inagaki. I thought Wilarot already in front of Yuki Ito, but I believe there's a backmarker. So still, Yuki Ito is leading that small group behind Inagaki, Yudhishthira and Koyama. And he's 7.8 seconds behind Zamri and Takahashi, and around 3.4 seconds behind the group in front of him. So he's looking good for Yuki Ito for race one. And well, he still has to start 16 from the grid in race two as well. And Yudhishthira Tira is already back in third place in front of Tomoyoshi Koyama. And so a small battle between these three riders for the third place final spot on the podium.
And Inagaki is trying to just hold on. He's just biding his time, is Makoto Inagaki there. Reminder, we're on Twitter, ARRC20. Do send your tweets in to us. You can catch us on Facebook as well, Asia Road Racing Championship. We'd love to hear your thoughts and comments about the racing. It's getting red hot out on the track. It's getting red hot in terms of temperature as well. And Yudhishthira currently holding on for P3 as Takahashi and Zamri Barber are disappearing into the distance.
Track temperature now is 54 degrees Celsius. Air temperature is around 32 degrees Celsius, so it's getting warmer out there. And it was doing well for the medium front and medium compound for front and rear tire, as we can see. Yuki Takahashi and Zamri Barber, well, they're still maintaining 1:05 second in the race. 1:05.283, 1:05.245 is the best for Takahashi and Zamri Barber.
The lead for Takahashi and Zamri ahead of Yudhishthira is around about 3.7 seconds, so they are decimating a high quality field. Battle for P3, Yudhishthira. Keep an eye out on Inagaki. I tell you what, the Aquino speed racing man, he's just sitting there watching the other two dueling, and he is just ready to pounce should the opportunity arise. That is Inagaki in currently in fifth place.
He's beating, just looking at a two rider in front of him, and Koyama, any mistake, and he will definitely take advantage of it. But from 4.5 seconds right now, Zamri and Takahashi leading the group of Yudhishthira, Koyama and Inagaki, and only 0.8 seconds between Takahashi and Zamri Barber.
Five seconds to go, I tell you. Takahashi's got a 1 second lead over Zamri Barber. Takahashi has just pulled out a little bit, and Inagaki looks like he was looking to make a move there. Yudhishthira holds on. Yuki Ito still holding on to six, but under intense pressure from Ratapong and Dimas Eki. We've got three racers within the subcontext of this race. There is Ito battling in. If only he hadn't made that error of judgment yesterday, he could well be competing up at the top end.
That's the price that Ito had to pay right now. He's sixth in the race and leading a smaller group. His place is not really safe yet, because within a second behind him is Ratapong Wilarot, Dimas Eki, Farid and Jackie Francois.
Now that's the Suzuki of Noriyuki Haga, just ahead of Rafi Tsusito. The two Suzukis competing with each other. Mitsunori Okamura from Bikart Racing Kawasaki and Haslan Shah also in that mini little group there. But great to have Suzuki back on the Asia Road Racing Circuit. But Haga would like to be a little bit better than the 10th that he currently is.
Yeah, Suzuki having a good rider in Haga, and also Rapid Tepan Sujipto, a former Moto2 rider and a former champion of the Undermoon category in ARRC. But then this is the first racer that's still learning the German technique of ARRC. But well, not bad for Haga, who had a good start in the race, but now 12th in towards three laps to go in the race. So this is the group of Yuki Ito. I think Ratapong just made his move. Ratapong Wilarot down in front of Yuki Ito. Yes, number 59 is in front of number 76 of Yuki Ito.
Yeah, Yuki Ito, that slip sliding away. He's beginning to struggle holding that front end. And as you say, Ratapong has just been waiting to pounce for him. So Ito is down to seventh. Ratapong up to sixth. And the AP Honda Racing Thailand team are looking for some decent points in the standings. Up at the front, though, I can tell you, Takahashi is 1.4 ahead of Zamri Barber. As they go past us on the start-finish line, we're looking at the minor placings here. Inagaki up to fourth ahead of Koyama, who's dropped off a little bit of as well.
Ooh, a huge group in front, and now we have Farid Badrul Hisham now right behind Yuki Ito, with Ratapong leading that group. Oh, quite a gap now.
This is Takahashi.
Takahashi and Zamri.
Yeah, Takahashi has bided his time. and the lead is over a second and a half, and Zamri, I think, is destined for second.
There's
more problems. It's the Suzuki's.
Is that Haga of Rapid Topan? We're not really sure.
Right, this is Yudhisthira. Now, Koyama's got himself back in ahead of Inagaki. Two laps to go, but Inagaki has just waited and waited. Now is putting pressure, going around the outside. Oh, there was a potential touch there.
Yeah, that's still Yudhisthira leading this group. Koyama trying to get from the inside at the last corner. Now, we are now on the last lap of the race, I believe. Yes, this is last lap. It is when we believe Inagaki will make his move. Inagaki is trying to get past Koyama. Now it's Inagaki.
Oh! Inagaki catches the tail end, and three men are down. Inagaki down. Yudhisthira down. Koyama down. Koyama trying to get back up on his bike. And frustration. Inagaki just caught Yudhisthira. This is the front end. Takahashi will go and take the win ahead of Zamri Barber, barring a catastrophe. But now in P3. Coming through, absolutely nowhere. This is Ratapong, who now looks like he's on a podium position. So Ratapong, his patience has told off. He's been able to benefit from the crash involving Yudhisthira, Koyama, Inagaki.
Well, what can we say now? This is, we'll be back in the front with Takahashi, but I would love to see who'll be third in the race. Takahashi with a healthy 1.6 seconds in front of Zamri Barber. Zamri second now, third in the race. Is between right now Wilarot and Farid Bandung Hisham, but it's looking good for Ratapong Wilarot to be third in the race with Farid Bandung Hisham. He's fourth, Demi Ika, Dimas Eki Pratama, Fifi, Yuki Ito sixth.
Yuki Ito sixth, Dimas Eki got past him in the latter stages, but real drama going into the final lap where the battle for P3 between three racers ended up with catastrophic results, as all three ended up not finishing. Maybe they're trying to get back up. I know that Inagaki was trying to. Yudhisthira was involved there as well, but it was Inagaki just getting too close to the back of Yudhisthira that caused all the problems. But there is the race winner, Yuki Takahashi. That's a dominant performance from the Japanese.
Yuki Takahashi and Muhammad Zamri Barber, they continue the dominance of the Musashi
chips. Takahashi takes the victory from Zamri. It's 1.573 seconds. Ratapong, that's a bonus for him. Farid Badral in fourth place. Dimas Eki ahead of Yuki Ito, whose tyres just didn't last, exactly as you predicted, Harmy. Jakrit in seventh. Fadli Mahmoudin, Rafid and Haslan Shah complete the top ten. Suzuki in ninth place on their return to the Asia Road Racing Championships. Aitchison Koyama picking up points. Is it a bonus? I suppose it is in many ways, because he could well have been out without anything after that crash in the last lap. Yudhisthira, my word, nothing for a brilliant ride. That's tough. We're off to a commercial break. We've brought you plenty of excitement. We'll have... For the second time today at the FIM Asia Road Racing Championships, it's the strains of the Japanese national anthem, because it's been a really good day for Japan. But a really nice day as well for Ratapong. That's a bonus for Ratapong Wilarot. He thought he was battling for P6 or P7. In the end, he's got himself a place on the podium, Harmy.
Yes, indeed, for Ratapong Wilarot. It's a surprise for him. And while this is racing, anything can happen. Zamri Barber, a second on the podium. A good start for Zamri. And this is Yuki Takahashi winning his first race in ERRC for Musashi Bonshu Honda Racing. And also the team award for the Musashi Bonshu Honda Racing, Zulkifli Zuhelmi Ahmad.
Encikwan Zaharuddin Wan Ahmad, the president of the FIM of Malaysia, providing the awards. There's the prize winners, and now the photo opportunity. Confirmation of how the race was won, and let's show you Bye, fellas. Confirmation of the standings. 25 points for Yuki Takahashi. Zamri Barba, 20 points. Ratapong, 16. He'll be very, very happy to get that further down. Rapid Tsutito, the best of the Suzuki riders. He came ninth. Kind of a bonus for Koyama. He did get up on his bike and got going again to pick up 4 points. A reminder, you can contact us on Twitter at ARRC20. Also, join our Facebook page. We'd love to hear your comments.